afternoon, dear student. I am Najmul Sahib, lecturer in Business Studies, Vishwamana College, Chitradurga. So, in previous video, we have seen about the concept of communication. In the concept of communication, we have discussed about the meaning, definition, as well as the elements or the components of communication and importance of communication we have seen in a previous video. And today's video, we are going to discuss one more important concept called formal as well as informal communication. So, please do not get confused in formal organization and informal organization and formal and informal communication. These two are different, okay? So, usually students get confused in formal organization and informal communication, okay? You have to see, you have to read carefully while answering, okay? So, communication taking place in the organization can be broadly classified into two categories. One is formal and another one is informal communication. So, formal communication here refers to the communication which takes place officially. Okay, the communication, the flow of communication through the official channels. Okay, which is designed in the organizational chart. And this organizational chart is created by, or it is deliberately created by the top level management. So, formal communication is nothing but the flow of communication through the official channels or official paths which is designed by the organizational chart, which is designed in the organizational chart by the top level management. So, this formal communication can be take place between the superior to the subordinates, okay, subordinates or superiors, okay, or among the same cadre of the employees or the manager, among the same department of the employee or the manager. That is what we say formal communication. Formal communication is nothing but the communication flows through the official channels, okay, official paths, which is created in a organizational chart by the top level management. So this formal communication can be flowed between the superior to the subordinates, okay, the flow of communication among the subordinates, from the superiors to the subordinates, or from the subordinates to the superior, or in the same cadre of the employee, or in the manager, okay. So, the communication, the formal communication, it could be in a oral, or it may be a written, okay. It may be a orally they can pronounce, or it may be in the form of written. But generally, in organization, they will maintain the records and files, okay, that it will be in a written form. So, this formal communication has been classified into two categories. This formal communication has been divided into two categories. One is vertical. So, this formal communication has been classified or has been categorized into two ways, okay. That is vertical form of formal communication as well as horizontal form of communication. Vertical form of communication is nothing but, so communication flows vertically. So, here the communication or information is shared vertical form, that is from the downwards to the topward or from the topward to the downwards. So, here vertically we are going to flow the, or we are, the flow of communication will be there vertical form, that is from the top to bottom or bottom to top. So, here upward communication as well as downward communication. So, here under formal communication, there will be two categories as I told, that is a vertical. Under vertical form, here the communication will be flown upward as well as downward. So, communication will be flown upward or downward, that is what? In a vertical form. Okay, vertically we are going to communicate. We are going to pass the channels through the official channels. Through the with the help of the official paths, we are going to share the information. So here upward communication is nothing but here the subordinates. Here so subordinates to the subordinates. Subordinates to the superior. So here, in case of upward communication, the subordinates are going to communicate to the superiors. So, for example for the upward communication is granting for leave, okay, submitting your reports, working reports, or asking for the grants. This is all comes under the upward communication. So here you are going to communicate as a subordinate. You are going to communicate with your superior, with the management. This is called downward. So examples for the upward is called as granting for leave, asking for the leaves. Okay, you are going to ask as a subordinate or the employee. You are going to ask for the leave for your manager. Okay. Are you submitting your performance report? Okay, you are submitting your report to your superior. Okay, that will also come under the upward communication. And even you are asking for the grants, you are asking for some money, that is also comes under your upward communication. Okay, so coming to the downward communication, so it is fully opposite to the upward communication. Downward communication is nothing but superior to subordinate. Superior to subordinate. So here communication is flow from the top level to the bottom level. For example, for the downward communication is like issuing orders, okay, by the top level management to the lower level people, to the employees or to the subordinates. Okay, issuing orders, giving instruction, okay, issuing policies, okay, asking the employees to complete the task within a time. This all comes under the downward communication. So here informal communication has been classified into two categories. One is vertical form, another one is a horizontal form of communication. Under vertical form, the communication is flow vertically, that is what, upward as well as downwards, with the help of official channels, which is created in the organizational chart by the top level management. Okay, by following the official channels, by following the official paths, the communication is flown upward to downward. Okay, so upward communication here nothing but the subordinates is going to communicate with his superior. Okay, here subordinates communicates to the superior, that is called as upward. Downwards communication nothing but superior communicates with the subordinates, that is the top management or the superior is going to communicate with the subordinates. That is what a vertical, downward and upward communication. Next is what horizontal form of communication, or it is also called as lateral communication. Horizontal communication or lateral form of communication. Under horizontal communication, same department of the managers are going to communicate. Okay, so the same division, employees or subordinates, they are going to communicate with the each other. So here the horizontal or lateral communication take place between one division to the another division. For example, production manager is going to have a conversation. He is going to communicate with the marketing department. Okay, our marketing department is going to communicate with the sales department. Likewise, that is called as a horizontal, same way. Okay, same division, that is what we say, cadre level. Okay, same level we are going to have a conversation. It is called as a horizontal form of communication. So here the pattern through which communication flows within the organization is called as communication network. So in a formal organization, there are certain communication networks. There are some communication networks in a formal communication. So here they are going to ask one question: what is communication network? So communication network refers to the pattern are the manner in which communication take place within the organization. Okay, the pattern, the manner, the method in which communication flows within the organization is called as a communication network. So, communication network here refers to the manner, the pattern through which communication flows within the organization is called as a communication network, as I told you. Okay, so here under different communication network is operate under formal communication. There are certain popular communication network are there in your textbook that we are going to discuss one by one. The first one is, the first network is a chain network. Chain network of communication under formal communication is a single network or chain network. Okay, single chain network. This network exists between the superior and the subordinates. When there is a superior and subordinate relationship is there, the single chain of communication, network of communication, they are going to follow. In organization, there are many organizational structure. Okay, in organization there are many organizational structure. So the communication will flow from each superior, for every superior to his subordinates. When the flow of communication from the superior to the subordinate, then single chain network is used. That is what chain network or single chain network. So here superior is going to communicate with his subordinate, the superior is going to communicate with his subordinate. That is what we say single chain. Next is what wheel network. Under this network, in this wheel network, all the subordinates are under the one superior. Under one superior, the communication will flow only with him. Okay, only through the help of the superior. The communication will be flow with the help of the superior. So here, superior act as a hub for the wheel. Here, the superior act as a hub for the wheel. All the communication, if you want to communicate with any subordinates, first you have to communicate with your superior, then you can communicate with the another subordinate. Okay, so here the subordinates are not allowed to communicate among themselves. So they are not allowed to communicate among themselves. Instead, they have to communicate only with the help of the superior. That is called as a wheel network. Next, so the next one is circular form of network. So under this form of network, the communication will be flow in a circle manner. Okay, the communication will be flow in a circle. Okay, in a round form it is going to be flow. Okay, here each employee, okay, each subordinates can communicate with his adjoining subordinates. So here this particular individual can have conversation between the two adjoining is what, if he wants to communicate, he can communicate with him and he can communicate with him. Or if this particular individual wants to communicate, then he can communicate him and he can communicate him. That is what his immediate two adjoining individual or subordinates he can communicate. But under circular form of communication, the flow of communication will be very slow. That is what circular form of communication. Next is what free flow of communication. Under this type of network, the subordinates are free to communicate with any person they want. He can communicate to him or to him, anybody. Okay, there is no restrictions. Okay, here the individual are free to communicate with any individual in the organization. So here the flow of communication is very fast and very quick. Next is what inverted form of communication. It is very important question. This may be asked for the 2 marks again. Inverted form of communication. Under this form of network of communication, what happens? Here, the subordinates can communicate to his immediate superior. So, they are the subordinates. These two are the subordinates. They can have a communication immediately to his superior, immediate superior of these subordinates. And even as well as these superiors can also have a communication with the superior superior. This he is a superior and superiors superiors. These two can be joined. That is what. And later case of communication will be in a prescribed manner. They have the particular manner, the particular method they have to follow in order to communicate. So that is called as inverted form. Okay, inverted V shape. Okay, so here under this form of network, subordinates are allowed to communicate to his immediate superior and as well as his superior's superior. His superior to superior. So the further pattern, the further procedure they have to follow in order to communicate. That is what inverted form. So this is what the informal communication and their network. First is single chain, next is wheel, and next is circular, free flow, and inverted V. It is informal communication. So under informal communication, the flow of communication will take place without adhering the formal lines. Okay, the formal lines of the organization. Okay, so here the formal official channels, official paths, they are not going to follow. Instead they are going to follow. This is informal communication. Communication take place without following the official lines or formal channels of communication is said due to a informal communication. So here the informal communication refers to the grey point. The grey point is nothing but here the information is passed, okay, throughout the organization with its branches out going out of all the direction. Okay, so here information is passed with the help of the branches that are there, that are exist in the organization. The informal communication arises out of the needs of an individual to exchange their views, which cannot be done with the help of the formal channels. So here, in order to share their requirements, in order to share their feelings, this informal or communication will arises. Okay, so the informal communication arises out of the needs and requirements of the individual in the organization in order to exchange their views, in order to exchange their feelings, in order to exchange their thoughts and ideas to the another person. This cannot be done with the help of the formal channels. So here, for example, the subordinates or the workers, they may chit chat in a canteen. Okay, they will have a friendly talks. The rumors, okay, the discussion, the friendly talks, the friendly discussions are all examples of informal communication. So here, under informal communication, the information is passed very fastly and quickly. Rumors will be created. That is called as a grey point. So, as a successful manager, he has to identify the informal communication. He has to use this informal communication positively, and as much as possible, negative aspect of this communication has to be avoided. In order to know the feedback of any policy, he can make use of informal communication. Okay, in order to know the decision, in order to know the feedback, or in order to know the minds of the subordinates, the informal communication can be used. As a successful manager, as an intelligent manager, he has to make use of this for informal communication positively and avoid the negative aspect of this communication. So here, under informal organization also, there are certain networks of informal organization that they are going to be asked for the 4 marks again. Let us discuss the network of informal communication one by one. So here, the pattern of communication under informal communications are called as a network. So network of informal communications are the grey points are single strand network is nothing but under this single strand network the communication will take place in a sequential manner. One is going to communicate with another and another is going to communicate with another, next likewise, and in a sequential manner the flow of communication will be. That is called as a single strand network. Under single strand network, each person communicates to the another in a sequential manner. This particular person will communicate to him and this will communicate to him. So in a sequential manner, a person is going to be communicate is called as a single strand. Next one is gossip network. Gossip network is nothing but each person. Under gossip network, each person is going to communicate with the all on a non-selective basis. So here, each person under this network, he is going to communicate to all. So he is going to communicate all on a non-selective basis. Take for example, this particular person name is A. Okay. He may communicate with the him, okay, he can communicate with him called as B, C, D, E, F, okay, anyway. So he is going to communicate to all the person on a non-selective basis. As a individual, he can communicate with the E or he can communicate to the C, okay. Although he is going to communicate to the all on a non-selective basis, okay, non-selective basis he is going to have a communication, that is called as a gossip network. Next one is, third network under informal communication is probability network. So under probability network, an individual is going to communicate on a random basis. This particular individual can communicate with him or he can communicate with him or he can communicate with him randomly, okay, without any selection basis, without any priority, he can communicate with whomever he want randomly, okay, that is what we say probability network. Next one is cluster network. Under cluster network, a person is going to communicate or a person is going to share his ideas, thoughts, okay, whatever he may have, okay, only to those individuals whom he trusts in the organization. So under cluster network, what happens? A person is not going to have a conversation with all of the subordinates, but instead he is going to communicate with only those individuals, only with that particular individual whom this particular individual will trust. Say for example, he wants to communicate, okay, he wants to share something to some person, okay. So he is going to share that or he is going to communicate to only that individual who he trusts most in the organization. So among all this network in a informal organization, the cluster network is most practical and most used in the organization. That is what a cluster network. Okay. So under informal formal communication, the communication is not, they are not going to follow any authority, they are not going to follow any rigid procedure to communicate. They can communicate as they want. Okay. They can have a conversation to whom they like. Okay. So here the information will pass very rapidly. Okay, here rumors will be created, the friendly talk, okay, that is called, that are all the examples of informal communication. So here, this particular informal communication is also called as a grapevine, okay, grapevine. So under informal communication, there are different network, single strand network, okay, next is a gossip network, probability network and cluster network. These are all comes under informal communication. Next is assignment questions. Okay, so first one is grapevine is, there are certain, this is the multiple choice MCQs. Okay, grapevine is formal communication, barrier to communication, lateral communication or informal communication. You have to opt one which is suitable. Okay, that is what you have to opt one. Next is, what is grapevine? You have to answer for this grapevine. Grapevine is also called as, okay. Next is, what is inverted network? This particular question will be asked for the 2 marks. It is very important question again. Okay, here star marks. This is a 2 marks question. What is inverted V network? Okay. So that is there, that I have discussed in the video. Okay, you have to answer this question. And next is, explain the formal communication network. I have discussed five networks of informal communication. You have to explain one by one with the figures. Okay, this is what the assignment question for you people. Thank you.